Welcome to week 3 of Cultivating Peace. I'm really glad that you're here. This week we get to talk about one of my very favorite parts of this book. And I'll tell you all often that I love each part of this book, not because of anything I've done or anything I've written, but because of how my life was changed by absorbing these truths that I want to share with you in this chapter. So this particular chapter is learning to trust God and His Word. And if you don't yet have a Bible, if you aren't really familiar, or if reading your Bible is not common practice, that is okay. But I want you to consider picking up a Bible, or at least getting a Bible app on your phone where you can search out scripture, where you can kind of test out what God might be saying to you. Because God and His Word are always the same. If you feel like God's telling you something and it doesn't line up with God's Word, then it's not right. So when we talk about trusting God and His Word, it's important, because if we're going to base our life on living out the truth of His Word, we need to know that it's trustworthy. Now, in this chapter, I give you quite a few ways to look through your Bible, give you some background information on it. It's very, very brief, but it's just to kind of orient all of us to the same page about the Bible, that it is living and active and breathing, and it is God's divine word given to us to guide us through whatever it is we're facing. But when we're facing chaos in our lives, it's often the first thing to go. Our time with God to listen to Him, to read through the Bible, becomes the thing that we push off to maybe if we have time later. What I want to tell you is that that act alone actually invites in the opportunity for more chaos, because it removes from us the truth of God's word. And so we end up hearing and listening to the lies, the ways of our world, and all kinds of other things that end up giving us a distracted time of being. And I don't want that to happen to us anymore. And so today I want to give you just a little demonstration. And you may have seen some of this before, I'm not quite sure, but this is your life, right? I talk about it in our book, that if you think about our life as a container garden, that the actual planter represents our life. And in here is the rock of our foundation of a relationship with Jesus Christ and our salvation, right? That is the foundation. And when you do some gardening, did you know that if you have the rock at the bottom, your roots of your plants are able to drain better and are able to become healthier and thrive more? And so it's important for us to have at our foundation the rock of Jesus Christ, because it does help us to thrive. That's how we connect with God. That's how God's word starts making sense, right? So we have that. And in chapter 2, we talked about the very first cup of our super soil is the fact that God loves you right this second, right now, without you having to do or prove anything else to Him. So I'm going to put that in here now, because that's our first cup of His super soil, right? But in chapter 3, I introduce 4 key promises of God's word. And I want you to know God's word is filled with hundreds of promises, hundreds. And they are true for you as they were as true when they were written, and they will be true in generations from now. It's understanding how they apply to your life that matters. And so what I have done is I've chosen 4 scriptures that were key to my life and the way that God encouraged and inspired and changed me. And I put them in terms of promises. So the very first promise that I share in our book is the fact that God's peace is available no matter what we're facing. It really is. You know, we get caught up in thinking that, oh my gosh, life is crazy, life is overwhelming, where is God? He's not here. The thing is, He is there. He's right there with you. And He's waiting for you to turn and trust Him, to hand over all of the things that you're struggling with, and instead allow Him to take them from you to calm the chaos of your life. The second promise that I chose is focused on this this way of, I guess, of thinking about it, and it is that God is in control even when life seems to be chaotic. So often we think that God is in control and everything's good when our life is calm, when we see the blessings, when we are living a life that we think is great, and we're like, yeah, this is good, God is good, it's all great. But what happens when our life hits those speed bumps that we're going to have? When chaos comes, when trouble comes, what happens? Well, God is still in control. He's still there. Often, our mindset, which we'll talk about in the next chapter, is keeping us from receiving His peace. But I want you to know that God promises that He's there no matter what kind of chaos you're facing, and we have a choice about looking for Him and seeking out His peace. The third part of soil that I talk about, third promise, is that God will guide us through the chaos. There may not be a way to go over it or around it. We're going to have to go through it very often. But God will always be there to walk us one step at a time through whatever chaos that we're facing. It's not always in our timing, and it's certainly not in the ways that we think it should go, but God will always guide us through that. And the fourth thing is this, that God's plan eliminates the unnecessary. How many times have we said yes to something when we know we should have said no? How many times have we kind of added things into our lives? We're like, oh man, this is probably not the right thing to do, right? Those kinds of things, if we're trusting God to lead us through our lives, He's going to help us eliminate what doesn't need to be there, including, you know, doing laundry, I think was the example I have in there, and giving us time to rest when we need to rest. But what I wanted to make clear is that building a relationship with Jesus Christ as our foundation and submitting our ways to the ways of God, to trusting in His word, to trusting in His promises, creates for us this massive vine. Now, if you are familiar with John 15, you understand that the Bible talks a lot about that He is the vine, that Jesus is the vine, and we are the branches. And the Bible in the New Testament talks a lot about if you're cut off from the vine, you cannot produce fruit, but if you are abiding in Jesus, if you are following His ways and listening to Him, you will produce fruit. Well, think of it like this. This particular plant is one of my favorites. It is one single plant, but you can tell that it has, you know, different blooms here. You can see the different blooms. It has different parts and pieces to it. These things can all survive and thrive only when they're connected to the main plant. This is what it is to develop a healthy, quiet time with God, where you can connect yourself to Him, reinforce that connection to Him, because the world wants to try and pull you off. It wants you to turn away from God. It wants you to do your own thing because you can get it figured out on your own. Well, can I just tell you that trying to figure it all out on my own about killed me? And even today, the decisions that I have to make, the things that I'm facing, if I tried all the time to figure it out, I would make myself a nervous wreck. And I know some of you are experiencing that too. But what God says is you can let Him be in control. He'll walk you through that. He's going to eliminate the unnecessary, and His peace is going to be guiding you all the way through when you choose to submit to Him and spend time with Him through studying His word. These things will guide you. And I want that so much for you, because if we can remain connected to God in all that we face, I believe that we will come out of each thing stronger. Now, I want to caution you here. Choosing to walk away does not mean that somehow you're cut off from God. He doesn't leave us. He doesn't. The story of the prodigal son is a prime example. The Father's always watching for us to come home. We may walk away from Him, but He doesn't walk away from us. He doesn't let go of us. He's not unaware of what we're doing simply because we've walked away. He is with us. What He wants for you, though, is to thrive. And the way for you to thrive, the best way for you to thrive, is to remain connected with Him. That's why this concept is so important. When you are willing to give Him your time in your day to learn about Him, to study the ways of Jesus, to study God's word, and put it into your mindset and into your heart, you are able to thrive despite whatever it is that you face. And it's hard. It's not like all of a sudden the door opens up and the angels start singing and the light shines on. You're like, oh, it's all great. It doesn't always happen that way. Sometimes trusting Him is painful, and it's hard in the waiting, and it's overwhelming when you go, where are you? Are you sure you're there? Those kinds of questions are so okay. So if you're in the middle of some chaos right now and you're like, I am studying my Bible, I am paying attention to what God's trying to do, I just don't know where He is, can I encourage you to hang on? Because that plant is going to bloom. I don't know when, but it will. And in the meantime, use the nutrients found in God's word to continue nourishing you, to strengthen you, to give you encouragement. Meet with others to talk about God, to talk about Jesus, to talk about His ways, to reinforce that for yourself. Because we are going to go through that. Cultivating peace isn't about calming all that chaos. It is about trusting God. And when we have a huge season of trusting of the unknown, because we don't know where He's going, we don't know what He's doing, we can still receive His peace when we turn to His word. That's why this week your assignment is to schedule in some time to be with God every day. Please make every effort you can to do this, whether it's the first thing in the morning, whether it's in the afternoon, no matter where it might be. Please take some time to do that this week. May this particular lesson bless you. May it guide you into a deeper relationship with Him. I'm looking forward to talking with you next week. And in the meantime, if you have any questions, please just reply to this email and let me know. Thanks, and I will see you next week.